Hey guys, my name is JessiMew, and welcome back to the Hard Mode Island Challenge, where in the last episode, Adam and Eve attempted to start their family on the Hard Mode Island, and I guess they succeeded. I mean, we have a couple skeletons keeping us company right now, but we are still alive, so that has to be a win in some form. Right now, though, we do actually need to focus on getting some stronger creatures in the pack, because we were kind of ambushed by multiple carnivores in the last episode, so I'm a little bit worried, especially now that Adam has passed away, that if that happens again, we might get completely destroyed. Adam, of course, had the poison fangs, and he was a little bit stronger than some of our creatures are right now. Like, I think most of our creatures just have a 1 in strength at the moment, and that's not going to be enough to protect us from carnivores, especially if they start swarming us in hordes again. I mean, unfortunately, this guy back here, who is our newest addition, our little spotty cheetah, doesn't even have a strength stat. He is primarily a scout, I guess, and I'm thinking maybe we could send him off to one of our other nests. I mean, unfortunately, they are so far away that I'm a little bit worried to separate our pack like that, but we do definitely need to get another nest in the pack too, because right now we're only focusing on one nest, and that's just not enough to give us enough opportunities to have more babies born to the pack at once. So we need to find another nest in this episode. We need to hopefully get some stronger babies in this episode, and I think what I'm actually going to do is place the claw right in the mutation menu right now. We already have a few nimble-fingered creatures in the pack, so I think it's much more important that we have the claw with us now, that we somehow mutate the claw onto our pack members, and of course those antlers as well, because I did notice that the antlers are actually carried in Duke-to-Duke's genetics, so hopefully that means that he'll have a little bit of a higher chance of passing that along to his babies. And in fact, what we probably want to do is have him breed again with Koana right away, because their lives are getting a little bit close to the end. We have 11 days left on Koana, and we have 8 days left on Duke-to-Duke, because he took a little bit of damage, I believe, in the last episode, so we probably want them to shuffle around right now to have another baby very, very soon. We just need to make sure that these babies are protected. So we have Kutata right here, who is unfortunately bleeding at the moment. Oh, I thought we fixed that in the last episode. Maybe he's still bleeding. Okay. So we'll actually have Kuduk here maybe go over there and lick his wounds. Maybe that would be a good idea. Like, we want to just make sure that all of the babies are protected. And right now, Rasira can't move. She was literally just born, so she can't move off of the nest just yet. So we could actually have Kutata move right here. And then Kuduk here could lick his wounds right there. And then I guess we'll leave him right there for now. I guess that would be okay. I think this little baby will be safe because Kuduk here is sitting right next to her, and actually I don't think the bird is even in our skies right now, so I think we'll be okay for this turn, but we will keep a very, very close eye on her once we pass the day. And for now, we can have Koana start moving this way to go breed with her mate again. She'll use her last point of energy to breed with her mate, and there's the bird again. Good thing we have a little baby on the nest, because that bird would definitely go try to steal it if it could. So let's actually have our little spotty cheetah gather up a couple more of these berries for his last turn, and then I guess we'll go ahead and skip the day. Did I just see something rustle back there, though? I think I did. So there's something right here too. Oh, that is not good. That is not good. Let's hope that it's not a carnivore, because this poor guy is not going to be able to defend himself at all if it is. Let's go ahead and skip the day and watch very, very carefully. Did it move? No, it didn't move. Okay, so I guess that's a good sign. I guess that might be a good sign, but I'm still very, very worried. So I guess Rasira will move you right here. Aha, it's another bird. Okay, so we have to get Koana back to the nest very fast. There we go. So we managed to get the nest back before the bird came over, but let's have Duke-to-Duke pick some more berries for us, because we do need to keep a very close eye on the food situation too. Luckily, it is raining right now, so we are in a better position than we were before, at least when we started the game, but we'll have to make sure that we're not taking on a higher population than we can actually control right now. Let's just have Duke-Dukta at least pick a couple of these berries before he moves down the shore. I think if we actually take him along the beach, we might be able to get there faster, though I'm going to stay very close to the grass simply because I'm hoping that we can like stumble upon some good resources as we're going to the nest. And hopefully he doesn't get ambushed too. Like, that is going to be very, very sad for him if he does. The reason why I'm sending him in particular, though, is because his genetics don't really mix with our pack very well. He has hemophilia. He has a strong immunity gene B. He has blind eyes in his genetics. Like, unfortunately, he just really doesn't mix well with our current females, because I believe most of them already have immunity gene B. Yeah, the youngest, Karam, she has immunity gene B. And then I was thinking Rasira could possibly breed with Kadukir because they both have completely different genetics. So it might be a good idea to have them start a family as soon as they're fully grown. But let's cross our fingers that this baby has a claw, because that is going to be very helpful if it does. But I guess we can skip the turn now. We'll go ahead and skip the turn again and hope that nothing comes jumping out. So far so good. So far so good. But unfortunately, this one did not manage to inherit the claw or the antlers. Oh geez, we are really running on short time though. Like, we absolutely need to get a creature with at least the claw. At least the claw before any more carnivores spawn. We're like racing against the clock at this point. So let's see, I believe unfortunately Kawana is the only female who is fully grown right now. So this is a very, very tricky situation because she's the only one who can give birth. So I guess we'll move her back to her mate and have her try to have another baby, though somebody needs to protect this one. So let's actually have Kutata move right here so he's protecting both of the one-gemmed babies. And then I guess we'll start moving her right back over here again. We'll have him breed with her this time, and then she can scoot back toward the nest, I suppose. Or she can peek in the grass for that matter, just in case, so those carnivores don't spawn right here, because we did have a little bit of trouble with that. And then on the next turn, we'll have her move to the nest when she can actually sit in the nest. So that should be fine. We'll have Duke to Duke pick his berries again, and then he can stay right there for now. We'll have you guys pick your berries too. Rasira, thankfully, because she has the nimble fingers, should be able to come down here and start picking up the shells pretty soon. And we're definitely going to need that extra source of food because we already have 8 creatures in the pack, and I'm going to keep breeding until we manage to get one with the claw, hopefully. And they're definitely going to end up being one of our alphas so that they can eat first. But for now, all you can really do is pick the berries, and then we'll have you guys continue carving your path off toward this nest, I suppose. Let's actually have you make your way this way. Nothing yet, unfortunately, and we do still have this nest safe and sound. I noticed, like, this bird is really eyeing up our nest right now. It is just waiting for us to move off of them so that it can steal them, and we definitely don't want that to happen. So let's see. Oh my gosh, a bunny. Oh, don't mind if I do, but wait a second. Oh my gosh, he can't actually attack the bunny. I forgot about that. Oh, that is so unfortunate. Well, at least we know that there's probably a bunny burrow right over here somewhere. So if we kind of like scoot him into the grass on the next turn, then hopefully that means that he'll be able to find a little bit more resources, because there could be a nest up there too, I suppose. There's probably some berry bushes at the very least, because the bunnies do like to hang around the berry bushes. So let's see, why don't we actually mark off Kudukir with a special gem, just so that we know that he's going to be breeding with Rasira when she grows up. So when she gets her second gem, we'll place the little orange color on her as well, just so I don't forget about them. And I guess for now, you could come up this way and you can try to like peek in a little bit more of this grass too. We can have you clear out a little bit more of this grass just to keep us slightly safer than we were before. And I think that's about all that we can really do with this turn. So let's go ahead and skip the turn yet again. How many times can we possibly stay safe on the hard mode island? Has anything spawned yet? I don't think so. I think we're still safe. I just feel like we're running on borrowed time right now. But look at that, we unlocked the big ears, so that's pretty good. I guess we explored enough of these little desert tiles, hopefully anyway. And then we'll have Duke to Duke, of course, pick his berries. We have another bird over here. Oh my goodness. Well, let's have little Mila move over here between the cactuses, and then Koana can move right to the nest, and cross your fingers yet again that we have the claw born on this baby. We just need the claw to mutate on one of our pack members, and then it should be a little bit easier to pass in the future. Hopefully anyway. Now let's move you a little bit further into the grass to see if there's anything in here that we need to take note of. We'll move him right here first. No bunnies yet. How about in here? Oh my gosh, there's just a bird over here. Really? Really? Is that all that's here? Well, there's the bunny burrow. There's the bunny burrow. But I was really hoping that we were going to run into some sort of berry bushes along the way, because we definitely need more sources of food at this point. Let's have Rasira come over here to collect some of the berries, and then she can actually clear out some of this grass in the next turn. As long as it's lit up, then we know that nothing can spawn here. I'm a little bit worried leaving these patches of grass right in the middle of our pack, because something could definitely spawn there and mess us up. And that's just a bird, right? That's just one of the birds. I did notice that something was moving in there, but I'm pretty sure it's a bird. Yeah, it is. They keep getting me so worried because I can't remember where they were. We have so many around here. But it might be a good idea to actually follow them at some point, because they might know where those nests are. And for that matter, we could start expanding this way too. Like, maybe this area would be a little bit more plentiful. I mean, we just need to run into some good luck at this point. Some good luck and no carnivores, hopefully. So I feel like we should probably keep Kutata right here just to keep track track of all of the babies, because we are still going to have to move Kiwana over to her mate again by the Perry Bush. So we'll leave him right there for now, and we'll skip the turn again, and watch all of our pack mates, make sure nobody's having any troubles. I think everybody's okay, but look at this little baby. Oh my goodness, you are adorable. You have the water body. Where on earth did he pull the water body out from? Really? Really? There is no water body in your parents' genetics at all. I have no idea where he managed to get that, but that is excellent. Okay, so he has the antlers. He has the antlers, and that gives him a 1 in strength. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. But the water body is actually not really helping us because it doesn't give him any extra stats and strength at all. So this is not the best situation. At the very least, though, he can definitely go into the water and collect us a little bit more food, and we are running low on that right now. We are definitely running low. We have like one more turn where we won't have to worry about anybody starving, or possibly two more, because if we have Rasira pick up this little berry, then we have 18 pieces of food left. So hopefully we can find another berry bush or something. Or maybe we could send a couple creatures out to attack these crabbits, because those will also give us some meat. That might be what we have to do. And let's see, can you find anything out here? I mean, if he could only find like a nice big berry bush out here to eat from. No, just bunny burrows. Tons and tons of bunny burrows all around our island. I mean, honestly, I guess that's a good thing, because we do know that there are some sources of meat on the island, but unfortunately, this guy can't even collect from them. So he may have not been the best one to send out on this mission, as it turns out. Let's have Kiwana scoot right over here to have yet another baby with Duke to Duke, though. I think that's all that we can really do, and I wish we had another nest. Oh my gosh, I wish we had another nest so she could have her next baby on the very next turn, but we're going to have to make do with what we have at this point. So unfortunately, Mila has not grown up, which means that Kutata needs to stay right next to her so that she doesn't get swept away by the bird in case it does spawn in our skies. Though again, I think it's very quiet right now. It doesn't seem like the bird is out and about. We did have a situation with two birds in the last episode, though, so that's why I'm a little bit concerned about that. I guess at the very least, if we move you right here, then we could move Kutata right here instead. And then maybe we could get somebody to help him, like, tag team this guy. We could even have Kiwana move right here. Oh my goodness, look at all of these crabbits. Oh my gosh, we have so many crabbits here. Let's have Kiwana hit this guy, and then we'll see if maybe we can get rid of him. Let's see, one more hit. No, unfortunately it's still alive. So on the next turn, maybe we'll be able to get rid of that crabbit and pick up its meat. Hopefully anyway. And then if we could actually bring Rasira down toward the shore, maybe she could gather up a couple of the shells for us instead. But since she's going to be moving toward this nest later anyway, she might actually be able to pick up some shells along the way. And then Koram, let's see, is there anything that we could really do with you? Why don't we actually have you go this way? We'll have her wrap around this way to see if she can find anything on this side of the island, because maybe we're just going in the wrong direction. Maybe all of the luck is on the western portions of the island, toward like the killer island for that matter. We'll go ahead and give that a try. Maybe that'll work out. And I guess we'll skip the turn again. I'm keeping a very close eye on our little cheetah back there, though. I'm afraid he's going to get ambushed in particular. It looks okay. It looks okay. I'm pretty sure I heard some Doflamingos spawning in the grass, though. And there's something right there. Oh, geez. Hopefully that's just a bunny. But first, let's actually go ahead and pick up some of this food, because we definitely need this. We are in dire need of more sources of food right now. So we'll pick up that. We'll have these little babies shuffle around. We could actually put Rokiro, like, right here in the water, because he has the water body, so he should be perfectly fine. And then on the next turn, he could actually pick up the shell as long as it's still there. We'll have Kiwana sit in the nest and hopefully have her next clawed baby. We'll have Rasira pick up this shell and the berries too. There we go. So that was kind of lucky that it spawned right next to her. And I don't see anything rustling over here. Okay, there it is. So it did actually move, which means it's probably not a carnivore. Let's see if we can see what it is. Bunnies! Oh, all of these bunnies! That is so sad because he can't actually attack them. Okay, so let's just make sure that this place is clear. It seems to be. And we do have a tree right here, which means that we could actually collect the acorns. And for that matter, we do have this tree right here too, so we could collect the acorns from this side of the island as well. Let's just make sure that it's safe though. We'll have Karam move over this way. We'll have her sit by this tree for a moment. So she can't collect from the acorns because she doesn't have the nimble fingers or the cracker jaw. But if we have her clear out a little bit of this area, then hopefully she can make it safe for the nimble fingered babies to use in the future. For now, Duke to Duke, oh my gosh, I think this might be one of your very final babies. He might be able to have one more baby before he passes away, but then we're going to have to really scramble to figure out who else is going to be breeding on this island to hopefully pass those stronger genetics. Now, Mila, you have two gems, so you don't have to worry about being protected anymore. We could actually have her start moving off this way too to hopefully find some more sources of food for the pack. And then Kutata, let's have you sit like right here for now, just to light up the area a little bit more for us. And I think that's about all that we can really do for you guys, though we do want to move Rasira's gem over to orange. There we go, just so that we know that these two are meant to hopefully have a baby in the very near future. And in fact, she should be growing up on the very next turn, so we might get started on that right away. And I think I'm going to leave the mutation menu exactly the same for their babies. I don't think we really have to worry about changing it too much. She only has one gene of hemophilia, and his genetics are perfect. He has the normal eyes, he has the normal blood clotting, so I think we'll be just fine in that regard. The big body though, she does have the big body in her genetics, and that's another thing that I was wondering if maybe we should try to pull out, because at least that would give us a guaranteed +2 in strength, and like we desperately need that right now. So that is a possibility. For now, let's have you start moving this way because we do want you to be a little bit closer to the nest. Okay, I saw that bird move up there, but I wasn't sure exactly what it was at first. I thought it was a wandering creature, but I think we're okay. It's just a bird. So let's move you right over here. And I think we might be out of turns at this point. We could actually have Duke to Duke maybe move right here to peek in a little bit of this grass for us. And then I think we are officially done. So let's see, is this baby hopefully going to have the claw? Still no claw, and I hear the bird. Oh no, I hear the bird in the skies, and there is our carnivore. Oh great. So now we have to figure out how to get rid of this carnivore without very strong creatures. Most of these guys only have one in strength, so it's going to be a very, very long and brutal battle for them. So first and foremost, let's actually move Rasira over this way to pick up a couple shells for us, and then she can scoot right over to her new mate. We'll have him breed with her just so that we have a baby ready to be born as soon as she gets the nest. That way we can at least rest assured that this side of the island will still be able to hopefully thrive. I am quite worried about Duke Duta though. Let's see, if we move him right up here, maybe he could possibly find a berry bush for us. Yes, he did! Oh my gosh, you are our savior! We actually managed to find a berry bush up there. Now hopefully no bunnies are going to spawn up there and eat up all those berries on us. We can have Duke to Duke move back to his berry bush at least to pick up the rest of his berries, and that at least gives us enough food to last us through the rest of this turn, though we are going to have to scramble to find more food after this. So I guess let's have you attack the carnivore as much as you can, and then you're going to have to run away as far away as you possibly can get. I feel like that might not be far enough away to guarantee that she won't get hit by him. I'm not sure. I mean, at the very least, we can move Mila up here to hopefully peek in a little bit more of this grass. Unfortunately, there's no more berry bushes up there, though. And then we have to keep a very close eye on these babies. So if we move Kutata maybe right here, there we go. Then we can find another one of these shells. So we could actually move the little baby right over here. And then on the next turn, as long as the shell is still there, at least we'll have another little piece of food to pick up. And the bird is way over here, so hopefully it's not eyeing up any of our babies right now. We do still have the cactus plants. We do still have the cactus plants around, so if we absolutely have to, then we could take one of our aged creatures and have them pick from the cactus, maybe, just to give us a little boost in food. But for now, I think the only other turn that we can make is with Kaduk here over here. He could actually move a little bit further into the grass to hopefully snag one of these bunnies. Like, what if we leave him right here? Because I have a feeling this is probably the bunny right here, so maybe it'll actually hop close enough for us to snag. Now let's see, is this carnivore gonna go straight toward us? Oh my gosh, it definitely is. Luckily, the carnivore could not hit us. It still has 12 days left on its life, so we are really going to have to make quick work of this guy before he gets to our babies. Let's see, 10 more days. Yeah, so basically, since they only have 1 point in strength, they can only take off 1 day on their lifespan a hit. And what's worse is Mila is not fully grown, so she can't really do much damage for us. And we probably just want her to run away, in fact, so that she doesn't get completely shattered. Let's have her move a little bit deeper into the grass, and we're going to have Karam move away from him yet again. We'll have Duke to Duke pick his berries, and I think we are going to have a situation where a few of our creatures are definitely going to starve. Rokiro can at least pick up the shell, And he does have two gems now, so he should actually be safe. He could move away from the adults and be just fine. And hello, little bunny. Where did you come from? Let's have a Kadukir move down here and snatch this guy right up. There we go. All of these bunnies. Oh my gosh, they are coming out at just the right time. We can have Rasira come over here and snag a few of them. There we go. That was all right. And I see all those birds moving back there and they're getting me nervous, but I think we're okay. And we have a Crabbit over here sitting here with a Dukduta, but unfortunately he can't attack them. You can, however, pick up these berries. So at least we have that. And look at that. We actually have enough food to last us through this day now. So that's excellent. We can move the little baby right over here so that his mother can actually pick up a couple of these berries. And because of that, I'm not sure if they're going to be able to have another baby in time. Oh my gosh. Though honestly, since this is his last day, he doesn't really need to sit by this berry bush anymore. So let's have him move over here and then she can breed with him one last time and we'll give it one final try to hopefully mutate the claw onto their babies. Hopefully, like that is all that we need. If we had a creature with a claw, then we could definitely take care of that carnivore, and then we would have a nice bounty of food too, because they give us 10 pieces of food once we get rid of them. Let's have Mila move into this little spot so that she's a little bit further away from the carnivore. And then what can we do with you? I mean, you only have 5 days left of your life because unfortunately you had a little bit of trouble early on with the carnivores. But we probably want to move you at least near Karam so that you guys can try to keep the pack safe. Like, we just need to keep the carnivore away from the babies at this point. So let's move him up here to peek in a little bit of this grass so that he's at least in the area. And then I think we are officially out of turns. So let's skip again and let's see where he's going. Oh my gosh, he is definitely locking eyes with poor Karam. And Duke to Duke, oh my gosh, he ended up passing away, of course. Of course. So let's move Kirinu right here on the skeleton of his father, unfortunately. We'll have Koana pick a couple of the berries, and then she'll sit right in the nest. And we'll cross our fingers yet again that we're going to have a creature with a claw. And there are the two birds. So we definitely have two birds on the hard mode island. Two birds working together to try to completely destroy our pack. 9 days left on this guy, so we might actually be able to take care of him. We might be able to if we swarm him correctly. Let's see, we'll have Karam slap him a few times. We'll have Kutata jump in here and slap him a few times too. And I see there's some more bunnies jumping around back here, so hopefully we can grab another one of those. Let's see, we have 4 days left on him. So even if we move Mila in here to slap him too, then we're still going to need one more creature in here to completely finish him off, and I don't think that's going to happen. Oh my gosh, so he might completely shatter either Kutata or Karam at this point. I think that is very, very likely. So let's at least have Mila jump in here and give him a few good hits. And we have some leeches moving around down here too. I just noticed that. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. A creature. A crackerjaw creature. Oh my goodness. And she has the claw too. That is exactly what we needed. Oh my gosh, the game has actually pulled through for us. So let's actually invite her to the pack because we definitely need you. Now, unfortunately, she does have the blindness gene in her genetics and she does have hemophilia too. So I mean, that's not exactly the best situation and we are certainly not going to breed her with Dukduta because that would kind of spell disaster for us. But at the very least, she could pick up the acorns that are already here. And we're probably going to have to take care of these crabbits too, I just noticed, because they're kind of blocking our way at the moment. So we might have to have them, or no, they can't double team, can they? Of course, because our little spotty cheetah does not have any points in strength, so he's just actually going to have to peek in all of this grass. And we'll have Russis, I believe her name is, kind of like move around the crabbits for now. This guy is on our nest though. He's on our nest, so we have to take care of him before we can actually use the nest. That is not good. That is definitely not good. I guess we're going to have you guys start making your way down here. Oh my gosh, a berry bush. We actually missed a berry bush on our way to the nest. Oh, that is terrible. Okay, so Rasira, why don't you hop this way? Unfortunately, the bunnies have completely consumed the berry bush too, so we're going to have to wait until it grows back or maybe until we get another rainfall. But yeah, let's have you guys start moving up toward the nest again so that you can get rid of these crazy crabbits. We'll have Rasira move right here next to the nest, and then on the next turn, hopefully we can have them kind of like double team this crabbit, though he has positioned himself perfectly so that his back is to the tree. That is quite interesting. Hopefully we're not going to have to wait for that crabbit to pass away, because that is going to take way too long. Now I think the last thing that we have to do is have Rokiro pick up this little shell right here. And then that might be it. The most that we could do is have him move down the shore a little bit to hopefully spot out some more of the shells for us to collect later. But here we go. I guess we're going to have to see which creature this carnivore decides to kill off. Oh my gosh. Oh, he has damaged so many of them. Unfortunately, Karam is now bleeding, but at least she doesn't have hemophilia, so we should be able to fix that. And yeah, Kutata, this is your very final turn after all of that bloodshed, so why don't you actually finish off the carnivore for us? There we go, and then you can gather up all of that lovely meat so that we have a little bit more food to use in the future. Oh my goodness, so at least he managed to give us a nice bounty of food on his very last turn, at least there's that. And then we could actually have Mila come down here and pick up the berries. There we go. She's actually the best suited to that for the moment because she does have the two running legs. And oh my gosh, does this baby finally have the claw? Oh, that is perfect. The claw and the big body, actually. So what is your strength like? A 4. There we go, a 4. And actually, her brother also has the big body too, doesn't he? Excellent. All right, so we are getting Adam's blessing back into the pack, apparently. The strong genes are slowly but surely filtering back into the pack. And now let's see if we can hopefully get this crabbit to move off of our nest. Okay, so Rasira can still actually hit the crabbit, which is very good to see. We'll go ahead and have them swap turns, hitting the crabbit until it hopefully passes away. Hopefully, there we go. So let's have Rasis actually pick up the crabbit meat, and then we'll have Rasira sit right on top of this nest, and we'll cross our fingers that we have yet another baby with the claw over here. We will definitely have to figure out who Rasis is going to breed with, because we want that cracker chaw to stay in the pack. Unfortunately, it's another situation where she has basically the same immunity genes as most of the rest of our pack. In fact, Kaduk here is exactly the same. He has A and B, so that wouldn't really work out between them. Though we do have a couple more males back here, so let's just take a quick sweep of which males we actually have. Kirnu, again, has A and B. Oh my gosh, what kind of luck is that? And Rokiro has F and B? Okay, he has F and B. He does have the short-sighted eyes in his genetics, so their children might be born with a short-sighted trait. But at least we have a different immunity gene on him, so that is a possibility. And of course, poor Kutata. I mean, he is definitely not going to make it up there to have a baby. So at this point, I think Rokiro is probably the safest bet. And it wouldn't be too bad either, because she has the cracker jaw, he has the water body. I mean, maybe that would actually make a pretty good match, because then they could kind of sweep around the water with the water body and look for more shells. That might be a good idea. For now though, we'll have you pick up your berries and peek in a little bit more of this grass to hopefully keep us safe. And then a Kaduk here, you could actually keep your mate safe by looping around this way, just to make sure that nothing is in the grass back here. Oh my gosh! Oh my goodness. All of these crabbits. This is way too many crabbits for one place. Oh, we are going to get completely swarmed back here of all of the things that we could be having trouble with right now. Of all of the possible things. I mean, I guess it's better than carnivores. I guess it could be worse. We don't want Rokiro to move too far away though, because if we're going to have him breed with Rasis, then he shouldn't be too far away. So we'll have him actually move it this way to look for more shells. Unfortunately, there's nothing there right now, but hopefully on one of the next turns he'll be able to find them. And I think this little baby will be safe, right? Are the birds actually gone again? No, it's way back here. Okay, we only have one bird left though. So we might actually want to bring one of the adults back here just in case. I think the baby will be fine being protected by someone with two gems, but just in case. Just in case, because we don't want our clawed baby to get swept away. That would be absolutely terrible. So let's have Karam. Well, actually, we need to have Kutata lick her wounds first. There we go. We don't want her bleeding out now. We'll have Karam move around this way to sit next to the baby. And then Koana can sit over here and pick up a couple of these berries for us. And yeah, I think we're going to have to go crabbit hunting. I think that's the moral of this story. We're going to have to go crabbit hunting very, very soon. We could actually have Kiernu start moving toward this tree as well so that he can pick a couple of those acorns pretty soon. We are yet again getting a little bit low on food, so I do want to keep a very close eye on that. But otherwise, I think we're doing pretty good. Let's have Koana move up this way to light up the area a little bit more. And I guess we'll go ahead and skip the turn. So let's see, hopefully this baby way back here is going to have the claw. No, it doesn't look like it, but she does at least have the antlers. And I'm just making sure that nothing else is rustling in the area, but I think we're okay. Just wanted to make sure. Yeah, she does not have the claw, but she does have the antlers. So I mean, at least we have a little bit of strength on this side of the island, but mostly the powerhouse is definitely Rasis. So we'll just have to keep her very, very safe, and we will definitely have to go crabbit hunting now. Yeah, I think we definitely want to get these guys out of our way at least so that they're not stealing any more nests. So why don't we actually have Rasis and Kaduk here do a little bit of hunting. We'll have her kind of loop around this way, I guess. Though wait a second, she could collect the shell for us before it gets swept away. And then we can have Kaduk here move right here to help her slap this little crabbit. And oh my gosh, there's even more coming out of the water. Like, where on earth are they spawning from? Do they spawn from the rocks or something? I'm not sure. This is crazy. We have way too many crabbits on the side of the island. And unfortunately, they weren't able to kill that one right away. So we'll just have to pick up the rest of our berries on this side of the island. And hello, little bunny. Hello, little guy. We need somebody to protect the baby so that we can have Rasira jump out there to try to grab the bunny. Let's have Dukduta move right here. And yeah, unfortunately that made the bunny scoot away. So I'm not sure. We might actually have to wait for that bunny to come out of the darkness. Let's do a little bit of work on this side of the pack while we wait for that. We'll have Koana on her very last turn. Oh my gosh, collect her berry. And I don't see that little bunny yet. Yeah, it has definitely scooted away. It might actually be going toward this berry bush, though. That might be the case. I guess at the very least, we could at least have Sira pick up the acorns, because she's one of the only ones who can do that right now with her nimble fingers. So we'll have her pick up the acorns, we'll have Dukducha at least shake the tree for us. There we go, that's plenty of acorns! Plenty of acorns for us to use, though honestly, oh my gosh, once these guys start passing away though, once they start passing away on their own, we are going to have so much food to collect on this little portion of the island. It is going to be a feast of crabbits. We're definitely not having that sort of trouble over here, but we will keep a very close eye on it just in case it gets that bad. So I guess to end out this episode, we can have Mila pick a couple more of these berries. We should probably actually have her move on this side of the bunny burrow, because that might give us a chance to have some more bunnies spawn right up here if she's not too close. And then Kiernu, we wanted you to start moving toward the tree. It seems like he's safe from the bird. The bird isn't really interested in a creature with two gems and a big body too. It would probably be a little bit too heavy for the bird to pick up. And we do want Rokiro to start moving toward Rasis very, very shortly. So maybe we should actually have him scoot along this way. Keep an eye out for any shells, though unfortunately I don't see any down here at all. So no luck for him. We'll have Karam sit right next to the baby, of course. And I think that might be about it for this episode. So surprisingly, we are still alive. We've only had a couple carnivore instances, and we are slowly but surely regaining strength in the pack too. So I think we're okay at this point. I think we're doing okay. We're kind of struggling along with food, but like I said, as soon as we start knocking off all of these crabbits, we should be in a very, very good situation, especially because we have all of these acorns to collect, we have all of these berries back here, so I feel like this side of the island in particular might be thriving pretty soon, but we'll have to wait and see, I guess. So for now, thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye, guys!